The recent video where I experiment with modding an old motherboard so it works with this old Xeon to play games like Overwatch with perfect performance is one of my favorite trash top experiments so far. Now, one of my biggest regrets is that that old motherboard supports overclocking, but the air cooler I was using was already so close to its supposed thermal limits that some new sort of cooling was needed. And a lot of the comments section seemed to agree that the solution was water cooling. I was very reluctant to get into something that I knew so little about until Banggood offered to provide a couple of all-in-one liquid coolers, because if there's one thing I get a kick out of, it's trying products from Asian brands that I have never heard before. I was sent two 775 compatible coolers, but I'm going to save this one for something that I want to try later, and go for this one, Ultimate CPU Liquid Cooler. With a name like that, what can possibly go wrong? All-in-one coolers work by moving a heat-conducting liquid from the CPU block to a radiator with a fan. It took a bit of fiddling to get this thing installed, given that so much of the instructions were in Chinese. Great easy-to-follow drawings, though. And I got the CPU block on the wrong orientation a couple of times, but after I was done, it was a sight to behold. If the internet has taught me anything, is that you cannot call something gaming until it is covered in freaking lights. For the purposes of testing, I will continue to use 8GB of DDR2 RAM, and since the CPU is going to be the focus, I will substitute the GPU for a GT1030. I am really tired of moving this freaking huge thing around anyway. Let's get back into topic. In overclocking, you're usually trying to get the highest frequency possible while keeping CPU voltage down and temperature within controllable limits. I spent hours experimenting with different values and monitoring results using both CPU ID hardware monitor and CPU Z, and putting the CPU to its limits by using OCCT. That way, we test for overheating and stability. The result of this experiment was a core voltage of 1.248 volts with a CPU frequency of 3.753 GHz. This is quite the increase from our original 3.13. Any lower voltage and I get a blue screen when doing stability testing, any higher frequency and the test shuts down due to overheating. The CPU reaches some really alarming top temperatures while stress testing, although while gaming, our current cooling will definitely suffice to keep it within the recommended 65 degrees, as you will see in a moment. So how much of a difference this makes? On the last video on this topic, I showed that one thing I could not get the CPU to do was play Battlefront 2. Well, infamous for a good set of different reasons, this game serves as a good testing ground because of how CPU intensive the Frostbite engine tends to be. Last time I tried, the Xeon caused horrible stuttering that made the game unplayable. And now, look at this. I followed some of the extra tricks from my video on the topic that I did for Laptop Mag, and the result was very interesting. The game can suffer slowdowns when loading a new area, but once everything is loaded, it can maintain very high levels of performance, definitely over what I expected, and temperatures are indeed under the 65 degrees. Water cooling really does make a difference. I also saw improved performance of PUBG. I forced an internal resolution to 50%, yes, I do plan to make a separate video about that eventually, and the CPU limited performance was really good most of the time. Some unexpected drops are typical of PUBG, but very high numbers in general. Nice. Not so nice was a short test that I did on Battlefield 1, using some of the tweaks from my video dedicated to that game. Well, this game uses the same engine as Battlefront 2, it tends to be even more CPU intensive. And while it does keep it together, there are definitely slowdowns. I would think the game's still playable, but it seems there is a limit of what this overclock can do. So is it possible to use water cooling to push the limits of an old CPU until it runs heavy games like Battlefront 2? Yes. Is this cost effective? Well, part of the beauty of using obsolete RAM and CPU is that you can get a lot of kick out of stuff that you can salvage from trash or just get very cheap. If you start buying water cooling, that kinda upsets that limit. But hey, blocks like this support all sorts of CPU types and generations, so that is an investment that is not lost. In any case, this was an interesting little experiment. Thank you to Banggood for providing the cooling system. More details in the link in the description. Remember that you can follow a lot of my videos as written articles in ModMy, also link in the description. Thank you patrons as well, some of the recent videos are requiring unexpected expenses, so I'm glad for those donations guys, really. See you around!